let's just say, choose as few as possible of remedies for a group. It's not like the complex homeopath people. The complex homeopath people, they think, well, the more we put in, the more we have chance that one of them is just the right one. Huh? It's right, huh? So, and they can continue to have more and more variations of more and more things put together in one pill, and actually it corrupts the whole philosophy and the whole reputation of homeopathy, because it does not, it's very unlikely that something still gives a result that has 10 or 20 or 30 remedies in one pill. Simply because it's just like when people sit at the same table and 10 people are talking. Information, it's exactly like this. It's too much information and it's not specific anymore. But also the classical ones, they are just as limited also because they think only one. It needs really two or maybe three or maybe four. But two is the way, it's the polarity principle. Yes, again, nobody has ever suggested something like this. I know this is the way, and I saw this already in India when I was practicing and learning homeopathy. I was living in New Delhi, and almost my neighbor was Rajan Shankaran. I read everything that he wrote, and this started also this connecting symptom pictures with actually with analogs in nature. So he wrote a new book, The Homeopathy of Reptiles. So reptile remedies. So because of course many people are reptiles. I mean, they are like snakes, like crocodiles, like
it's part in our brain, you know.
It's not talking about this. You immediately look for a biological, chemical, tissue place. No, it's information. So all what we see here is just the result of a program. See, that's it. When you see like a brain here, where's the brain? Where is it? It's in the program. And exactly, this is what you are. You are the manifestation of a program. Mm-hmm.
So we are the matrix.
The matrix, of course. But again, now people say, oh, of course it's a matrix. So they don't have to think anymore. See, they have another word. Be amazed about finding new things, not replacing old things, either with a picture or a word. So now,
can we say we are the same story over and over again?
That's what I said. That's the next step. But this is more philosophical. If you understand that you are a software, mostly the projection of a software, and the soul lives through this software, then you can imagine, and it's in many spiritual texts, that the same program has been repeated many times. Yes? So the software that you inhabit now has been used many times before, just like we use the core, 1,000 people use the same software. Yes? And so a consciousness works with the same informational blueprint. So now, help me while I'm saying all these things.
How we do the
trace. Simplicity. That's why I need my audience to get straight again. So, I have no problems with this to get lost. I have no problems to be in doubt. I have no problems to be uncertain. I have no problems to end up somewhere completely where I did not expect it. And all these things are the worst things that our education tries to bring to us. You have to know where you're going, you have to be, like for example, we were in the airplane, and then what do you want? And she said, Deborah said to me, like apple juice. And I said, two apple juice. And
then tomato juice first.
And then, or maybe she said it first, but I didn't hear it. So, but then she said, I want tomato juice. I said, no, this is Germans, you cannot change now. He said two apple juice, it's not possible. I was in my German floor, yes. Because they were already three people ahead, yes. And now I want to change from apple juice to tomato juice. Well, this corrupts the whole schedule. Huh? So, I mean, this is of course very German and Brazilian, because there's only one thing: beer. Second choice is beer. Third choice is also beer. Huh? So they don't have this problem. But see here. Now let's now be serious. Okay. Now I gave you those four principles. When you look at what kind of remedy trade do I want to make, let's say sensitivity, or one for protection, or one for love, or one for relationship, you can always think there's at least four different groups. They have four different, completely different directions, resonances, problems, and then you can start making those. I mean, this is the next level, and I know I will talk about this principle, about the quadrinity, for the rest of my life, because it's more complete, more complex, more powerful than the idea of duality or trinity or even of the non-duality. Yes? It's more complete and it's more practical, and all healing systems before have used one or another variation of this, like the ones which I like and it's more easy to translate is the alchemy, because of course they have the four directions, the four humors they call it, then the four elements, and then the Indians, they took two of them together, and they had the trinity of Avatar, Pitta, Kapha. The Chinese took two out of, built it apart, and they had the five elements. And of course, it's not really two only apart, the whole system really readjusts and has to be completely, we cannot make a translation between alchemy and Chinese remedies or Chinese elements. It's not possible, but it's always the same principle. To see what's the most fundamental, most archetypal, most structural elements, so we can look at people and say they need this or that. Yes, and this is really this is the whole challenge. This medicine, and this has been completely lost by what? By the American virus. You know, it's so absurd. You know what they say? We are all unique individuals. Yeah? So, that's why we all go to Walmart, that's why we all go to McDonald's, that's why we all go and see BBC News. It's opposite, you see, it's opposite to what America has brought to the people. It's a total brainwash. We are all individuals, totally unique individuals, and because they say this at any point, and holistic practitioners repeat it, doctors, politicians, everybody repeats the same old nonsense. That's why they can have McDonald's that serves millions and millions and millions with the same stuff. Huh? I'm getting excited because it's so absurd and nobody's seen this. Huh? It's the same thing that happens everywhere. If you focus, for example, let's say you have a complete idea that relationships should be giving total freedom to each other. Yes, let's say this is you philosophize all the time about this, you think about it all the time. I tell you, you can be sure that this person is more intended to control his partner than anyone. Mm-hmm. If you say we have to be true to it, and say there's another relationship issue, we have to really be true to each other. We have to tell each other everything. We have to not hide anything. If they talk about this a lot, you will know that these people hide mm-hmm. from each other more than anything. That they play games with each other. That they mm-hmm. trick each other. That they all these things. Mm-hmm. So you know, if somebody comes, you know because why? Because of the polarity principle. Mm-hmm. We need polarity. And now the problem, and that's the basis of all diseases when you get stuck in one cycle. And we have developed so many methods to get stuck that we cannot see it.
So, because it's really important for you, what would be, instead of the American virus, what would be the other polarity and what would be the middle?
Well, for example, the other side is India. And it's interestingly, it's exactly 12 hours difference on the other side of the planet. And I was interestingly there for 5 years, so that's why I can see it, know it totally from first-hand experience. And India is the opposite of America. So what the values are there? It's about everybody imitates everybody.
Tradition.
It's tradition. It's nothing is to be changed. They eat the same thing they eat 1,000 years ago. They dress the same way they dressed 1,000 years ago with the sari and everything.
Don't touch the cow even if you're hungry.
And the rituals. It's more solid than any other culture I know, and it's not moving. Also not moving for individuals. They say, well, where do you get married? Well, I hope I find somebody in the same street. Mm-hmm. Yeah? And if not, I'm sure my parents will. Mm-hmm. Yeah? And you see, then the Western people who think they are so bright, they say, are you crazy? You let your parents do this, and are you crazy, blah, blah, blah. They don't see that they have the American virus. That they cannot think the way another culture feels, experiences the world without the American virus. and they can be just as happy, just or unhappy as the Americans, because this is not the problem. It's not the problem. The problem is that the Americans are stuck on this side and the Indians are stuck on this side.
Yes?
About, for example, America is, everything is open to you. Everything is open to you. You can become the director if you're not the washer of the dishes, you can be the director. In America and in India, it's the total opposite. If your father was a dishwasher, or not only you, but your children will be dishwashers.
So then the middle point will be the ability to take advantage of both.
You want to think it out. You want to think it out. I'm just saying this is the polarity.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And in America, you think, well, I like really America more. This is much, much more real. No, it's because you're German or even just Western-minded.
Mm-hmm.
That's why you associate more with this. But the people in America see it a little bit. They start to see it because they're in the middle of this virus. They are running because there's no limit. There's no limit to what they can shop, to what they can make, what they can change, what they can... And that's the most superficial culture. India is the most deepest culture. Mm-hmm. Yes? So it's, in every respect, it's the opposite.
But there's existing no middle. We have the two extremes. Where's the middle?
The middle is always something only that is achieved by individuals.
Yeah.
It's not that we can create a society that's in the middle,
mm-hmm.
or we cannot create an individual that's always in the middle. It's a process. It's a process of what? Of DLE.
That's what I was saying. The ability in the individual to depending on the circumstances, to take the individualistic approach or the traditional approach without being stuck in any of this.
Yes, but how do you do this? And this is...
Change perspective.
Yeah, you can say change perspective, change thinking, change... No, but this is the thing. This is the thing. And this is the main teaching I want to bring. You cannot do it. You cannot do it yourself without the help, because otherwise you think you're making true choices, but you're just a little wheel in a whole mechanism. And it's true, we are, the mechanistic idea is very, very true, that we are machines and we are, the whole universe is a machine, a clockwork, it's very true. See, and this clockwork, the masses, you cannot change with the core, you cannot change, and that's why all the future is predictable. It's predictable by what, by the insurance companies. You can say how many people will die in a BMW next year, in which street, because it's predictable. That's why insurance companies never will make a mistake. So why is this possible? See, it clashes with completely with our all American virus idea that we are free, because how is this possible? Doesn't make sense. We are all free, and then insurance companies never make a mistake. They never really lose money because they can predict everything. How is it possible? Yeah? So it's, if you think about it, if you think twice, it all becomes really very superficial. Yeah? The idea of freedom, of individuality. You see, but this is number one and two in holistic and New Age philosophy. Yeah? Individuals, freedom. And nobody should ever come and limit this in any way. We are above this. This was in the old times of the Catholic Church and all these things. Yeah. So.
But was it? Is not the order there of the Knight Hospitallers to bring or to try to bring this DNE stage, or we would call it paradise, not to the right, not to the left, but in the middle. Is it not the end?
All organizations that are real, they always have this mission to bring both limitation, stability, matter, possibility, and then what else?
Unity.
Huh? Unity between people, and what else?
Energy.
Energy, change. Yes, change. And change in what way? By information, by the potential. As by the potential, by the direction. And so then it becomes a little universe in itself, and then it can create something, and can create the circumstances for change. And that's really why I know I cannot give instructions 1, 2, 3, 4, for example, doing now these what kind of remedies to take, how. We give you the method to set up groups, but then the core is necessary to do the evaluation. Yes? But let's look at this now, just from a very mechanistic